Hey, what's up, peeps? Welcome to another episode of Direct Edition. The channel is Fred Hall Direct Edition, man, and I just got out of the comic book shop, so I am very excited to show you my pickups. But before I do, let's get a sponsor checked in. And as you know, this episode of Direct Edition is brought to you by my fake Darth Maul from China. So let's get into it. Okay, peeps, first off, this is one of the Marvel Legends that I've been looking for. If I can't find the old school Toy Biz Marvel Legends, you know, I'll definitely look for the modern age one. And the reason why I got this Kamala Khan is because she doesn't have an old school Toy Biz Marvel Legends, of course, because she's a new character. But I really, really dig this character, man. Wow. If you allow my sexy hands to interrupt your video, let's take a look at her. Beautiful, man. Kamala Khan. My God, I don't know why I'm such a fan of Ms. Marvel. I just don't know, man. I just really like her, man. Like, even when she so-called went up against the X-Men for a second and in the Inhumans versus X-Men, I still was a big fan of Kamala Khan. I just like her, man. And, you know, people have some kind of gripes about, you know, her being, you know, stereotypical, you know, Marvel's trying to, you know, bring Muslims and all this stuff and oh, they're changing white male characters. Shut up. You know what I'm saying? Because when you shake up comics, eventually, if you've been collecting comics as long as I have, you know that they shake things up and then they go back to the norm. So it's only a matter of time before Wolverine turns back into, you know, Logan again. And it's only a matter of time before Tony Stark comes back, and it's only a matter of time before Thor, that's unworthy right now, is going to be worthy. So, shut up. But anyway, let's look at this Kamala Khan. Wow. In anticipation for my X-Men that was coming in, I did order the box, but Big Bad Toy Store had some difficulties. Like, they kept waiting and waiting, so I canceled my order. And I really thought about it. Do I really want that new X-Men wave? I do, but it's a couple characters I can do without. I definitely want the Dazzler. I definitely want not even Cyclops. I want Dazzler. I definitely want Longshot. I want to buy two Longshots and give one to Comic Book Window. But yeah, it's not that many out of that wave that I want. It's just like the Rogue One Black Series wave, so just as of right now, I just canceled my order, and you know, when I get a chance, I'll order it again. But right now, I'm not in such a mood to have the X-Men wave. That's 150 that I can use towards my NECA big ass Ninja Turtles. That's the real deal. But anyway, this is a look at the side of the box of Kamala Khan. Let's look at the front of her again. Very, very cool Sandman wave. And you know what I'm about to say, peeps, as we do on this channel, let's get into some comics. Okay, first off, we got some Uncanny X-Men goodness. This is Uncanny X-Men 188, Newsstand, 1984. And I think that's Madeline Pryor in the middle. I don't think that's necessarily Jean Grey, but I could be wrong. But yeah, man, just trying to get some Uncanny X-Men goodness. You know how we do on, you know, Direct Edition. I definitely love my X-Men and my Wolverine titles. So yeah, very nice. Once again, I found Moon Knight number one. This is a David Finch cover. Of course, every time I see this book, I'm going to pick it up. I think that David Finch did an awesome job with 1 through 10. I know the Punisher ended up appearing in this series, so definitely had to pick it up, man. I love David Finch's Moon Knight. I didn't know that Mark Spector was such a weird, crazy kind of dude. I know he went up against Bushwhacker in this series. Man, I mean, very, very cool, man. Very cool. All right, now, so you know in these videos, you know, Direct Edition, sometimes I have the coin, the dumbass moment. So I'm in Second of Charles, and I'm like, oh my God, there's some more magic books. I have a chance to complete my run. Womp, womp, womp. I bought, I got 1, 2, and 2, 3, so I definitely have to get that 4. And I just left a comment on one of my homeboys' videos telling them, hey, you know, I need that number four. And, you know, we're just going to coin this a dumbass moment. But at least I have one through three, and I have two number three. So I just can't wait to get number four. But yeah, this is Storm and Ileana Magic, the four-part miniseries. So very cool. Plugging in the holes and plugging in the gaps. So this is my second copy of Generation X number two. I definitely want to get two copies of number one. The reason why I love Generation X is simply because of their main villain, who is Implate. Hold up, I'm in the dungeon. I got to show you this. Hold up. All right, now, welcome back. So this is the X-Men Legacy Implate. The reason why I bought this out is because, like I said, the reason why I like Generation X so much is not only because my baby Jubilee is in the X-Men Legacy, it's also because of their main villain, Implate is a mutant who basically he's like a vampire. He's like a mutant vampire of mutants. Like he sucked the marrow out of mutants? It's disgusting, his power, because he actually has like these like hands, and in his hands there's a mouth, and he will actually like siphon off the powers of mutants, which is very cool but very nasty at the same time. But anyway, I just love Monette. He's Monette's brother. I just love the main villain of the X-Men Legacy. And if you look at the number two right here, that's Penance. And Penance was a mutant that Implate actually kept, you know, captive, and he would siphon off her powers and have her doing his bidding. And the Generation X first volume is all about, you know, Generation X helping Penance get over her enslavement by Implate. So that's a cool look at the front of my paperback, but let's look at the back so you can actually see Implate and see what I'm talking about. Now, this is a look at the back of it. You can see Implate. Implate almost looks like he has, to me, it looks like he has dreads, but I know later on they made him look like a younger Dracula 3000 or some crap like that, which is still very cool to me. That's Rogue facing him. This book is actually so freaking good. For a while, I had to hold off on it and not buy it because it was like such a expensive book. I guess people really, really liked this book, but it finally dropped in price in paperback, so I went ahead and bought it. You know, I'd have preferred hardcover, but hey, you know, if I can't get the hardcover, I'll get the paperback. But yeah, this is Rogue versus Implate, and inside the book, what happens is Implate, he has like a little minion called DOA, which is very cool because he's like a little like elf kind of demon. But anyway, Implate and DOA, they kidnapped the X-Men Prism, who I think is outed as being a lesbian. Not that it matters, but anyway, yeah, they captured Prism, and he was siphoning off of Prism's power, and Rogue actually, you know, went in that dimension which Implate was in and bought Prism back. So yeah, man, very cool, man. Love my Generation X. So a funny story is, before I went and saw the movie Logan, I actually went to a flea market, and the guy had a whole bunch of dollar comics, and he said, hey man, this guy came through and bought this thing called Luke Cage, Hero for Hire, and blah, blah, blah. And I was like, dude, shut up, man. You know what I'm saying? I don't want to hear about, you know, somebody finding gold before I found it. So I started digging through his books, and, you know, I saw this Reavers. And I was like, you know, how much you want for it? He was like, $5. I was like, you know what? I actually went for it. And I know that's a shame, but hey, you know, I don't have access to a lot of, you know, my Uncanny X-Men. So when I run across them, you know, I just buy them and I don't care. This is the Reavers. This is Mark Silvestri. You know, you got Lady Deathstrike. This episode is called Where's Wolverine? Come on, man. I don't care for $5. I'm going to get it. See, what you guys understand is YouTube deserves a better villain. And I'm going to give it to him. So if they told me to get it for $5, I'm definitely going to get it for $5. And you know, it is what it is. I kind of feel, you know, beat a little bit, but hey, what can you say? If you haven't seen Logan, man, the one that X-23 took off the head of, I'm almost sure that's Blockbuster. You know, the funny thing is, the whole time I was watching Logan, I was whispering to my kids, and you know, eventually the people in front of me was like, "Hey, who's that?" And I was telling them all the characters' names. So it was very cool to see Logan, man. If you haven't seen it, go and see it. And I was happy to pick up this book literally seconds before I went and saw Logan. So in the same flea market, I picked up this Batman and Robin 465, 1991. I saw it in somebody's video, so when I saw it in the flea market, I didn't even eBay it. I was like, you know what? I'm just gonna go off of, you know, what I think. And I got burnt because it's not worth $5, but it's all good. You know what I'm saying? Hey, we have those dumbass moments when we go hunting and we think that something's worth, you know, a lot of money or, you know, a certain amount of money, and it's not. Hey, man, that's the life of a gambler and a comic book collector. You know, you think that, you know, sometimes when you pick up a book, you're like, man, I think I overpaid for it. But you know what? In the long run, it's not about money. It's about the love of collecting. And I love this cover, man. This cover to me is worth $5, and I just really, really like it. And I appreciate the fact that it was in somebody's video, and when I saw it in a while, I picked it up. Okay, you got some more Uncanny X-Men goodness. This is Uncanny X-Men 276. This is Rogue versus Strong Guy, Guido. Very cool cover, man. I know Rogue probably mopped his butt in this book, but I didn't really read it yet. Very cool cover, man. I really do like it. Got it in second in Charles. Anytime I can find my Uncanny X-Men, my earlier versions. Did I say virgins or versions? My earlier versions. Man, I get really excited, man, because I really want to put together a very, very healthy Uncanny X-Men run, which I do have a very, very healthy run. But man, I just love to find Uncanny X-Men in the wild, or even X-Men, you know what I'm saying? Like, I want to duplicate, triplicate, quadruplicate my X-Men run. So yeah, pretty cool. And the last Uncanny X-Men I have to show you today is Uncanny X-Men 532. This book was speculated to go higher in price, and it actually did. I don't understand why, but it's Greg Land. This is Quarantine. Me and Comic Book Window have the trade paperbacks of Quarantine. Quarantine is very good. This is when the X-Men go up against these crazy ass people that want to be X-Men, so they actually siphon off some of the X-Men's powers. Notice I said siphon off again in this video, but they end up getting the X-Men's power and throwing like a big party where all these people dressed up as an X-Men, and they became actually they took this some kind of serum where they began to like have powers of the X-Men, which is very cool. So Quarantine is the next arc after that where, you know, the X-Men started getting sick, and they, you know, they went couldn't understand why they was getting sick, and basically they had to quarantine themselves on Asteroid M. But this is a cool Emma cover. Like Emma Frost a lot, but Emma Frost would be Comic Book Window's very, very, very favorite woman villain, because his favorite hero is Jean Grey the Phoenix. And I talk about him a lot, and I'm trying to bring him on the channel, but you know, by him being in another state, you know, it is what it is. But yeah, Uncanny X-Men Quarantine Part 3. If you get a chance, man, pick up this run. You won't be disappointed. Greg Land's drawing is so cool. A lot of people is like, oh, it's a computer electronics and blah, blah, blah. I like Greg Land. I like Clayton Crane. I like Billy Tan. Jim Lee, Mark Silvestri, and David Finch. Definitely going to pick up those. And so, in every one of my videos, we have a main event, but you know what? I have so much exciting new comics that My main events is going to be, like almost like 3 to 4 parts. So this is my first part. This is I Am Bane, Batman number 17. Just check out this cover. Very, very cool. This cover is by my favorite artist. This is David Finch. The funny thing about this run is I said, hey, I'm not going to pick up any I Am Banes because I'm waiting until September until they go ahead and drop the trade paperback. I even talked to my boy Seeking Nimrod Comics, and I was telling him, how much I like the I Am Bane. And he was like, hey, Fred, I can send you an RKO, Random Act of Kindness. And, I'll send you the I Am Bane books. And I was like, nah, man, I'm going to pick up the trade paperback. You know what? Me being the biggest Bane fan of all time, I said, I couldn't resist, man. So not only did I get 17, I picked up Batman 18. Very cool, Batman versus Bane. Picked up number 19. Very, very cool. Look at that Two-Face, Riddler, Scarecrow. Very cool. And lastly, I picked up number 20. So the reason why I couldn't hold back is because, man, I ended up watching Rob Explain's channel. And he did the rundown of the book, and he said there's one part where Bane was fighting Batman, and he was like, look, I'm not a riddle. I'm not a penguin. I'm not a joke. I am Bane. And when I heard that one verse, it excited the Bane fan in me that I am, because, I'm a huge fan of Bane, mostly because of Tom Hardy, but even before then. But, man, when I heard that one saying that Bane did, I was like, man, I just have to pick this up. And it's drawn by my favorite artist of all time, right behind Jim Lee, David Finch. So yeah, man, I Am Bane. That's an early main event, I guess. So I remember telling you guys last video that I was in love with this Wonder Woman cover. So I had to go and buy another one. This is pretty cool. This is Wonder Woman number 34. This is a selfie variant. Every time I see this cover, I most likely will pick it up until I get 4 covers. So I bought the last one in my Archaic Comics, my local comic book shop. If you look at my last video, I showed you the inside of that store. I really love this Wonder Woman variant over selfie variant. I know that I think the Champions or Ms. Marvel or somebody has one. And that one is not touching this one. I really like this one. Really, really like it. Very cool. So yeah, this is my second copy. Wonder Woman number 34. Yeah, so before we go any further in the video, I just got a call from Tyler. And that reminded me that my footage from my vacation and showing you some of the Funko Pops that he picked up was deleted off of my vacation video. So right now we're going to take that chance and look at his video of his Funko Pops. So stay tuned, and right now we're going to show you the Funko Pops, okay? I actually wanted to steal it from Tyler, but hey, he knows where I live. So we got to the point in the video where you asked me, hey, Fred Hall, direct edition, what are you reading right now? And what I'm reading right now is my hardcover Wade Wilson's War. Now, this book is funny because what happened was I saw it for sale on Amazon for about $12. So I proceeded to say, hey, I get paid tomorrow. I'm asleep on it. And then tomorrow when I wake up, I'm going to definitely purchase it for $12. How about when I went back the next day to purchase it the next morning? Somebody had snatched it up for $12, and the book jumped up to 22 plus $5 shipping, so it jumped up to about $27. I was heartbroken. I was, mad. I was frustrated, but I say, you know what? I'm still gonna go through with the deal. So I went ahead and bought this Wade Wilson's War for $27. I'm glad I did because right now this is very sought after hardcover. This is a flashback of when Deadpool, Domino, Silver Sable, and Bullseye teamed up back in the day. This talks about his past, but the way the book ends, you don't know if Deadpool's, making it up in his crazy brain of his. But to me, it's head canon. Okay, head canon is when you take something that you say, hey, that's what I believe. You know what I'm saying? So I like that. I like this Wade Wilson's War. Very cool. So here's a quick look at the back of the book. Very cool artwork, man. I really, every time I read this book, I really enjoy reading it. This will probably be my second time reading it because I tried to hold off on this book, knowing that I like it so much. I was like, hey, I don't want to ruin it for myself. But yeah, pretty cool. Deadpool, Wade Wilson's War. What do you think about it, Fake Dark Maul from China? Okay, so in this video, it's pretty cool because you actually have almost like four main events. The first one would be I Am Bane, you know what I'm saying? Which is very cool. And this would be your second main event. This is the Uncanny Inhumans number one. Now, the only way I could have topped this find as Second of Charles is if I would have found number 11, which is the first appearance of Mosaic, who is like almost like an Allen Iverson character or something like that of the Inhumans. But yeah, man, when I saw this cover, like when I was flipping through a Second of Charles and I found this, man, I was so happy, man. Uncanny Inhumans number one. How can you beat that for $1.25? Very cool. And your next main event is X-Men Gold. Now, the reason why I put this as a main event is because I know it. Okay, I know all you guys have X-Men Gold, okay? But what you guys don't know is the guy who actually drew it actually put like very subliminal messages from the Quran in this book. It's very controversial right now. It hasn't been recalled. The reason why I'm taking this very serious is because I don't like racism, even though me being a black African American, my story. But anyway, yeah, man. So X-Men Gold has some kind of controversy going on with it, where the guy was, putting verses in the Quran in it, and just look it up, man. Because I was talking to the guy in my comic book shop, and he was like, hey man, this is this and this is that, and look it up when you get home. I haven't had a chance to look it up, but I'm just telling you, I don't want to gossip. I haven't confirmed it myself, but from what I know is that Marvel actually fired the artist on this run, and he wasn't apologetic. He said that, Jews run the world, and he put in a lot of the, I just, whatever. But anyway, we're not going to take the focus away from the X-Men being back together because, Marvel is trying to kill off the X-Men with the Inhumans. So I was very happy that I found out that they were doing the X-Men Resurrection. They have X-Men Gold. They have X-Men Prime, which I haven't had a chance to pick up. When I went in my local comic book shop, Archaic Comics, X-Men Gold was sold out, so I had to go way to Smyrna, Georgia, which is almost about 45 minutes away, to Titans Comics, and they actually had like four of these X-Men Gold lefts. So I was very happy to pick this up. I'm definitely gonna pick up X-Men Prime, and hey, this is what, your third main event. And for your last main event, which is the third book, let's see, we did the I Am Bane, we did the Uncanny Inhumans, we did X-Men Go. So this is your fourth main event. all new Wolverine number one. Man, I went to Titans Comics and I was like, hey man, Titan Comics, you know, y'all don't have anything old school. You know, I'm an old school head, so I guess I got to go way to my dojo, which is Dave's Comics, to get into the old school comics. But anyway, you know, I really don't collect modern, but I definitely was not subjected to the all new Wolverine number one. And I also want to get the newer one with the Uncanny X-Force or the X-Force outfit. I think that's all new Wolverine number 15 or 16. Anyway, when I saw this in Titans Comics, I actually let out an oh shit. You know, I was like, oh shit. And you know, so when I found it, and I found it for $5. So automatically went to eBay. I said, hey eBay, you know, how much do you sell this for? And eBay sells this book for more than $5. So man, I'm very happy to have this in my collection. You know, I'm a big Wolverine fan. You know, I'm a big Laura Kinney fan. I called her Kennedy in my other video. But yeah, man, this is your main event. All new Wolverine number one. I'm thinking about going back to Titans and buying another one. But hey, let's see what happens. So once again, I'd like to thank you all for tuning in to another episode of Direct Edition. The channel is Fred Hall Direct Edition. Remember, life is short. You know, you guys are not going to die with your money, so you might as well spend it. But at the same time, too, make sure you're, you know, smart with your money. And I will catch you guys later. Love and peace and head grease. Peace.